एंड वेलकम इन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल मेटलर्जिकल फैक्ट्स। सो दिस इज गेट 2021 सॉल्यूशन एंड दिस इज पार्ट टू। बिफोर दिस आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन द एप्टीट्यूड सेक्शन आंसर की फॉर एप्टीट्यूड सेक्शन। ओके सो दिस इज फॉर जस्ट बेसिकली फॉर एम्प्टी सेक्शन। सो एक्चुअली आई एम नॉट फीलिंग वेल, सो वट एवर द क्वेश्चन आई नो, वट एवर द सोल्यूशन आई नो, आई विल ट्राई टू प्रोवाइड यू थ्रू द यूट्यूब वीडियोज। अदरवाइज आई विल ट्राई टू आई विल ट्राई टू सप्लाई द पीडीएफ ऑफ आंसर की। ओके सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज दैट विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज सेंटर स्प्लिट डिफेक्ट इन रोलिंग ऑपरेशन। ओके सो दीज आर द सम डिफेक्ट्स ऑफ रोलिंग गिवन हियर। ओके सो द फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू कैन फाइंड दैट दिस इज वेवी एजेस। If you will go through the detail book and rolling part, you will get that these images directly. Okay, and this is zipper crack. These all are the defects of rolling. This is zipper crack. This is wavy edge. This is alligatoring. Okay, so the rest is center split. Okay, so this type of defect is known as center split. Okay, so here option may be differ in your response sheet, but this type of figure is correct answer. Okay, so this is center split. So here A part is correct and this figure is basically correct here. Okay. So the next question is very very nice. They have asked these metal forming processes in form of figures. Okay, so if you have little bit idea about these things, you can do this question easily. Okay, in examination also. So first of all, write P Q R S and find whatever you know. So rolling is the easy one. So you know what is the rolling? Rolling here they are doing this rolling. Rolling is basically for producing the plates and rails also between these rolls. Okay, so S you can match by 2. So this is simple form of eliminating the options. Next option is you can find easily that this container wall is here, this RAM is here, and this workpiece here. So in this case, you can find that this is the extrusion case. Okay, so Q is 1 and P is the punch. They are using punch and die. So punch and die is basically used in this deep drawing process. Okay, so P you can find match by 3. Next is next left one is the forging. Okay, so open die forging basically. So you know the reducing the height, that is also known as forging part. Okay, so this is basically they are doing the forging, that is pressing or applying mechanical forces. So R you can match by 4. Okay, so the code for this matching is 3142. Okay, so 3142 is correct. So here one by one you can find this is deep drawing. Okay, because in response sheet answer may be differ from options may be differ. Okay, so this second figure is for extrusion and this is for forging, that is open die forging, and this is for rolling. Okay, this is for rolling, open die forging. So you can match accordingly and code is 314. This question is NAT type of questions, and in gate 2021 you will find NAT type, mostly NAT type of question, that is that makes this question little bit tough, but because people may do the silly mistakes in this case. Okay, so liquid iron cast into the spherical sand mold that is 6 cm radius. Okay, so R is given here, that is 6 cm, and a cubical sand, that is A, is given, that is 12 cm. So if solidification time S is 60 minute in case of a spherical casting, means TS is given in a spherical casting, that is 60 minutes. So this is the correct way of doing this type of question. So they are asking the time for this part. Okay, so you know the Chevron rule, that is TS is equals to K V by A whole power N. Okay, so V by A is modulus of casting, that is ratio of volume by area. Okay, so volume by area in case of sphere will be like that, 4 by 3 pi r cube or 4 by 4 pi r square. So from here you will get 4 r by 3. Okay, and for cubic, that is v by a, c is equals to that is a cube by 6 a square. So from here you will get a by 6. So a value is 12 is given here, so 6. So 2 is the v by a for this cubic. So v by a for sphere is R value, you know, that is 6 by 3. So here also you will get the 2. Okay, so from here also you can find the idea that this K is constant, this N is constant, so V by A is also constant. So time will so time will also constant. Okay, so this this is the also correct way of doing this question, just by observation. Otherwise you can solve question here, that is TS is equals to for a sphere particle, you know V by A, so you can find the K value by putting this V by A and TS here. So you will get this K is equals to 15. I am not going to solve again. Okay, so TS is equals to 15 and V by A for cube is given, that is you will get 60 minute. Okay, so this is 60 minute is correct answer for this question. So the time will be same because modulus of casting is. So the next question is, single crystal turbine blades of nickel based super alloys for aero engines are manufactured by. Okay, so whenever they are talking about the single crystal for turbine blades, and this is the basically the type of super alloy, that is nickel based, that may be of cobalt based, that may be of Fe based, but these all alloys are manufactured by using directional solidification. Okay, so these three part is correct. So again, this question is very easy, and in gate practice series 17 I did this question, and this question was very simple, but I told you at that time they may ask this type of question in exam, no doubt, and they ask this question. Okay, so this question is very easy, R wide by R atom, and there I have told you the relation between this R wide by R atom for the octahedral voids in BCC. Okay, and I remember I told for everyone, for FCC octahedral, for FCC tetrahedral, for BCC tetrahedral, for BCC octahedral. So okay, so they are asking basically R wide. Okay, so R wide is equals to 0.155 into R atom. Okay, so in discussion section on Facebook, I saw that on the memory based question, they were saying that this is not radius. They give the lattice parameter. Just think that this radius is fixed for the Fe atom, so that it did not change. Okay, so R wide is equals to 0.155 and R atom is given, that is 0.124, that is in nanometers. Okay, so R wide in nanometer will come like that, 0.019. So they are asking for up to 3 decimal places, so you can quit here. So R wide is equals to 0.019. okay, so this is correct answer. So the next question is, which one of the following is false for creep deformation? The minimum creep rate is obtained in primary stages. Okay, so if you are sure, you can quit here this question, because you know that this minimum creep rate is obtained in secondary stage, not in primary stage. Okay, so this is the correct answer here, and the rest are the sentences. Creep strength, creep resistance decreases with the decrease in grain size. This is correct sentence. This is also correct. Koppel creep occurs by grain boundary diffusion and Navarro by a lattice diffusion. Okay, so this A part is correct here, because they are asking for false statement, not for true. Okay, so this is the false, because the minimum creep rate is obtained in the secondary stage, not in primary stages. Okay, so this first option is correct here. Question is also from basic mechanical metallurgy. Okay, so in gate 2021, you will find that they ask mechanical metallurgy very very much. Okay, so this is the basically mixture of mechanical metallurgy and thermodynamics paper. Okay, so that's makes this little bit tough, and people may do the silly mistakes here. Okay, and the some questions were tricky, and also some were the statements were given in not in straight manner. Okay, so the question is for uniaxial tensile stress behavior of polycrystalline aluminum, which one of the following is false? Again, they are asking about the false statement. Okay, so at the ultimate tensile stress point, at the true stress strain curve, d sigma by d psi d epsilon is equals to 0. Okay, so this is correct statement. Maximum true state does not correspond to maximum load, so this is wrong. You know, this is the basic thing, that maximum true stress, that is correspond to the maximum load. Okay, so true stress is always higher than the engineering stress, so this is also correct. Resilience is area under the elastic region. I already told you, whatever the region under the elastic region, that will be the resilience, and the whole area will be toughness. Okay, so this is also correct. So here they are asking for false statement, so 2 is correct, that is maximum true stress does not correspond to the maximum load. So 2 is correct.